Believe it or not, Thanksgiving is almost here. Maybe it's a difficult year for you to muster up thanks and thankfulness as a result of all that's going on. And today's passage from the Apostle Paul really helps us consider how we are to rejoice and give thanks to our Lord. And part of the reason why we're having this extended prayer time in the month of November is to prepare our hearts to give thanks to a God that ultimately deserves all praise and all glory and all honor. Philippians chapter 4 says this, "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatsoever is true, whatsoever is honorable, whatsoever is just, whatsoever is pure, whatsoever is lovely, whatsoever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you." The Apostle Paul makes some astounding challenges for us as believers. He said that we're to rejoice always. He says that we're not to be full of anxious or be anxious about anything. How's that going for you? What a challenge, right? And then it says this, that let this be your reasonableness. Now, we have reason to question the Apostle Paul's reasonableness, because he's sitting in a prison cell in Rome right now, awaiting a death sentence. Is it reasonable for a person to talk about praise and rejoicing and no anxiety when you're sitting in a prison cell? The Apostle Paul would say, yes, there is a peace that passes all understanding. And for you and for me, no matter what's going on in our lives, it is reasonable to have a heart of praise and to be able to rejoice in joy. The book of Philippians is the most joy-filled book, perhaps in the whole Bible. And it's in what we would consider one of the most dire seasons in the Apostle Paul's life. So as we turn our hearts towards Thanksgiving, realize that this world wants to take you by the hand, and it wants to walk you to a situation, and it demands that you become anxious about it, that you become afraid, that you become angry. Come here and look at this. You must be worried about this. Come here and see this. This should offend you and make you very angry. And often we allow the world to lead us when we turn on our phones in the morning, become upset by what we see when we turn on the news and we take one side or the other and there's conflict and chaos everywhere. Paul is saying that the secret is to think on good, pure, and helpful things every day. And ultimately, to take your hand away from the world's leading and instead to put your hand in Christ, a nail-pierced hand. A hand that you know was willing to go to the cross, to take on your sin, to handle your punishment on that cross. And this same Christ says, I will walk with you through all of life's challenges. I will be there in all of the difficulties and ups and downs of your life. I have already demonstrated my love for you by going to the cross, by taking on your sin, by giving you my righteousness. And I have mercies for you every single day. So how can we have a peace that passes understanding? How can we daily rejoice? How can we not be full of anxiety? It's by being reasonable. And isn't it reasonable to trust Christ after all that he's done for us? My prayer is that you have a very reasonable, thankful Thanksgiving. God bless you.